It is time for a new PhpStorm release. And this time we've made many improvements, including enhanced PhpDoc generation, as well as the addition of our experimental AI assistant, object shapes, support for Laravel Pint, and much more. Let's take a look. Let's start with improvements to generics. We've added support for combining template annotations with mixins, made it so that you can rename generic template names, and added support for static types in generics. While we're on the topic of type checking, PhpStorm now supports object shapes, which allow you to define exactly what properties are available on an object. It's especially useful when you don't have control over the original class or object definition and still want static insights. All of these features live in PhpDocs, so we made some general improvements over there as well. If you're only using PhpDocs to add additional type information, you often don't need redundant docblocks, such as for parameters that already have a type. PhpStorm can now get rid of those redundant docblocks for you, only keeping the relevant ones. Next, I want to talk about an experimental feature. We've added an AI plugin to our marketplace. Right now, you have to manually download the plugin and register to get access. And to be clear, there is a waiting list, so not everyone gets access at the same time. We have several experimental features like AI assistant chat, where you can ask questions or generate and insert code snippets. We have a bunch of new intentions that are powered by AI, which can, for example, explain code blocks, find problems, or generate documentation. You can also use AI to fill in docblocks for you and generate commit messages. You can use it to suggest new names when refactoring, and you can use it to explain regexes. Now, if you're trying out our AI features, you're also welcome to leave feedback, and there's a button in the AI assistant window to do exactly that. Next, we've added support for Laravel Pint so that PhpStorm will show Pint inspections in the editor itself. We also added built-in support for Qodana, our static analysis engine that brings inspections from PhpStorm to any CI pipeline. In other words, you'll get the powerful insights of PhpStorm in places like GitHub Actions or CircleCI. You can read more about it. I will leave a link in the description. Next, a pretty neat change to our version control integration. You can now make partial commits by picking individual changes within files to be committed. As usual, we've made improvements to our new UI as well. You can now choose a light header with a light theme. Headers are colored so that they match their project icon, and you can override that color if you want to. And you can also pin run configurations so that they are always on top of the run menu. Finally, we now have support for CSS nesting, a new feature in CSS, which is pretty cool. We've also introduced support for Sudo on SFTP servers. And crucially, we've added support for LSP, Language Server Protocol, meaning that plugin developers can provide coding assistance in PhpStorm. If you made your own programming language or framework, you can now get it supported in PhpStorm by creating an LSP server and a plugin. That's about it for this release. You can read all the details about it in the link in the description. Leave a comment while you're down there, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.